needs. To begin our program, it's my pleasure to introduce our tremendous Dean, Trevor Morrison, who is the Eric M. and Laurie B. Roth Professor of Law and Dean at NYU School of Law, to say a few words. Trevor.
Thanks, Josh, and good evening to all of you. I'm really thrilled to be here to help celebrate these two important milestones at the school, namely the 70th anniversary of the graduate tax program and the 20th anniversary of the international tax program. I should say, by way of confession at the beginning, I am not a tax lawyer. I'm a constitutional lawyer, which is to say that the only tax law I know was participating in an amicus brief a few years ago arguing that the right way to think about the Affordable Care Act's individual mandate was as a tax, of course. That's about where my expertise in tax ends, but not so my appreciation for this program, which is really deep and broad. In my just about 3 years here, I've come to see both the international tax program and the graduate tax program as true jewels in the crown at this law school, and really gained a number of insights I feel like I have about these programs. Both have had major impacts on the historical evolution of this school as a leading law school, not just within the tax field, but helping to position the school as a leading school nationally and internationally. In 1945, one of my predecessors, Dean Arthur Vanderbilt, who had the decanal immodesty to name this building after himself, sees the opportunity then to create the country's first graduate tax program. And this really was a prescient decision. I'll quote another of my predecessors, Russell Niles, who described the origins of the tax program and Dean Vanderbilt's role in creating it as follows, and I'm quoting Niles. Vanderbilt was not a tax lawyer. He did not even find the study of tax law congenial. But as an imaginative realist, he saw before any other law school dean what the impact of the new tax laws would be on the post-war world. And so with his usual audacity and vigor, he recruited a tax law faculty and with their help set up the most complete and imaginative offering ever made in this field. That was true then. Over 70 years later, it is true today. The graduate tax program has maintained its position as the premier program of its kind. It is the model, of course, that many other schools seek to emulate, but none doing so well as ours here. Second, I'll note that both tax programs, both the graduate tax program and the international tax program, really continue today to enrich the intellectual life of the law school and to serve each as vibrant centers of debate and discussion for tax practitioners, academics, and policymakers alike. The foundation of the tax program, of course, is its strong faculty, over a dozen full-time faculty members, over three dozen adjunct faculty members. The faculty is itself comprised of leaders in all important debates on tax law and policy, and practice, both domestically and internationally. During the last few years, to think about programs put on by the graduate tax program and the international tax program, we've hosted many dynamic conferences and events for students and alumni. Many of you, I'm sure, were in attendance at some of these, including a day-long symposium on Piketty's best-selling Capital in the 21st Century, featuring Piketty himself. A public lecture by Jason Furman, chairman of the White House Council on Economic Advisors, titled Business Tax Reform and Economic Growth. Weekly roundtable discussions with leading practitioners and government officials addressing international tax topics, among others. And many social events for students of both programs, including, amazingly, an annual tax movie night. I guess it can't be more frequent than annual, really, or we might run out. But it's been tremendous, highlighting the appearance of tax law in popular culture. The tax program is also a source of important innovation, and this is perhaps not always the way that everyone thinks of the program, but it really is a source of innovation within the law school in terms of pedagogical method, and in that sense, an innovator in legal education more broadly, even beyond this school. It is really hard to read about the state of legal education or higher education today without seeing mention of the rising role of technology in how we teach, questions of the role of online education in legal education. And we are a real leader in that space thanks to the graduate tax program. We are far beyond merely exploring online education. With our executive LLM in tax and our MSL in taxation, we're real leaders in online legal education in that space. And that marks us as important innovators in legal education generally. And third and finally, I've learned that one of the main reasons that our tax programs are so strong in these areas is that we benefit tremendously from the participation of our alumni, many of you. Our alumni support the graduate tax program and the international tax program by teaching as adjuncts, by speaking on panels and at other events here at the school, by mentoring our current students and recent graduates, and this really is tremendously important. We're very grateful to those of you who offer your time this way. And of course, through supporting the activities of both programs in philanthropic ways, through the Wallace Lyon Eustace Fund and the International Tax Program Practice Council. In all of these ways, your support really is indispensable to the continued success of these two programs. So I want to thank you for that. And I want to say congratulations to the Graduate Tax Program and the International Tax Program on these important two milestones. Dan Shaviro and a few other of us were just noting that the 75th anniversary is a natural time to mark the progress of a program, and so too 25th. So I think that means not later than 5 years from now, we should reconvene to continue to congratulate all of us on these programs. But thank you for being here tonight. Thanks very much.